Hey guys, Bobbery18 here, and welcome to my next Let's Play on Donkey Kong Country 3, Dixie Kong's Double Trouble. Personally, I think that this is a really underrated game, probably the most underrated game of the Donkey Kong Country series, in my opinion. Oh, and this is the intro here. I'm not doing this, is just like, the demo thing that they always have. By the way, the music you're hearing now is the best music that I have heard probably all week. It's actually the music I'm going to use for my outro, so listen to that when you can. It's at the end of the video, obviously. So yeah, that's pretty much why I'm doing this game. It's actually, contrary to most people's opinions, it's my favorite Donkey Kong Country game. Most people think 2 is the best, but I like this one better. It just held my attention better. Maybe it's because it's a little easier, but I'm not really sure. Anyway, here we have 3 files. That's just my practice file there. So I guess I can use this one. 1P game. You can also play with 2 players. If you play with 2 players, one will be Dixie, and there's also a new Kong named Kitty in this game. Dixie was from Donkey Kong Country 2, and why am I going backwards? The M is up here. I'm just gonna be naming it my actual name because I don't think Bobbery actually fits. I could probably put, like, B-B-R-Y or something, but that just sounds weird. I'm just gonna put Max. Luckily, I have a 3-letter name, so it's fine. You can also put numbers. I don't know why you would really want to do that. Then there's okay. I don't know why, but I always thought that was really confusing to do. I don't know. So yes, here we have Dixie. This is controlled automatically. I'm not doing this. I also didn't go into that cave, but she did it automatically. So this is pretty much all the story you get. Hello there, it's me, Miss Wrinkly Kong. I found life too hectic at school with all those naughty Kremlings pestering me all the time. Yeah, she's referencing that she was the school teacher in DKC2. If you need to save your game, Dixie, call me here anytime, and I'll record your progress on my VidMe What's It machine for you. Okay. So yeah, she's basically how you're gonna save your game. She has caves throughout the things. It's good to have a viz from you, Dixie. All you ever see on television these days is repeats. I guess so. Also, she had an N64 in the background. I should mention that this game, it's probably the most underrated because it came out, I'm pretty sure, like, a couple of months after the N64 came out. Some, like, 1996. So most people were, like, done with the Super Nintendo and they moved on to the N64, so nobody cared about this game. But I do, it's really good. And since it did come out at the end of the Super Nintendo's lifespan, it has, like, it's probably the most, one of the most advanced Super Nintendo games because, you know, as systems go on, they also get more advanced with their games. But yeah, yo Dixie, what's happening? I've been setting up my smoking new boat shop on this island, but that's not all. I've also brought your excellent cousin Kitty Kong along for the ride. So yeah, this is funky. Instead of running the flights in this game like he did in the first 2 games, he runs a boat shop where you can get upgrades for your boat and stuff. If you throw him, his humongous body can break through the floor. He has basically new mechanics from the other 2 games that I'll show in this game, but for right now we can select the motorboat. And something that is very different from the other 2 Donkey Kong games is, or the other 2 from the original trilogy basically, is that there's a giant overworld that you can now explore. Instead of just having like select levels you can go to, you can explore the whole overworld. This also will include some other things, like if you go up here there's going to be some extra collectibles that I'm going to be doing at the end of the game, just because it's sort of an out of the way thing that would be the proper time to go to. But anyway, enough explaining. Well, I'll probably still explain more, but let's go to the first world, Lake Orangatanga, with the first slide, Lakeside Limbo. So controls here, control pad to move, you know, B button to jump, Y button to do a spin attack. It also, if you hold it, you can run. If you press A and you have Dixie on the bottom, you can throw Kitty up. Yeah, he doesn't go very far. So, you can also switch Kongs with select, so if you do the attack with Kitty, you can throw Dixie a lot higher, and if you go up here, there's a 1-up. Balloons are the 1-ups, I guess, in this game. Your lives, I guess. They're only 1-ups in Mario. But yeah, you can pick up with barrels if you're just holding Y, and you can knock them into rats like this. I'm pretty bad at the official enemy names in this game, so excuse me if I don't get any of them right. That was one of the Kremlings. I don't really know its official name. So yeah, here's a use for Kitty. If you throw him up with the team jump with Dixie, he can break stuff, and this is where the first bonus barrel is. Bonus barrels, they help you get bonus coins, just like the first 2 games. It's required for 100%. Actually, this game has 100 105% actually is the maximum, but I'm only going to go for 103, because if you go for 105, you have to enter a code that makes the game a lot harder, and I don't really feel like that's necessary, especially because you have to go through the whole game again, so I'm not really going to be doing that. Also, here we have a coin spelled with a K. Yeah, how clever. They introduced Donkey Kong coins in the second game, but this is how you're going to be getting them to get... this is how you're going to be getting all the Donkey Kong coins in this game. They're always going to be held by coin there. They're also required for 100% for something that you will see way, way, way later in the game. Like, something involving those extra things that I said you'd be getting way later in the game that would be out of the way. Up here, there's another balloon, so I guess I can just throw Dixie up there to get it. Oh, there's a coin. Also, there's like three types of coins. There's the Donkey Kong coins, like I already explained. There's the bonus coins, which will be used for also something way later in the game. And there's also the bear coins, which will be used for basically buying stuff. They're sort of like the currency in this game. Like, I forgot what the equivalent is in the second Donkey Kong game, but I know that there's one that you use in there, like, to save your game at Wrinkly Kong's place or answer quizzes with, what's his name? I don't know. Just anyway, they're like, not a collectible. Or, well, they are, but they're not, they're unlimited, basically. So you don't have to worry about them. I'm over-explaining things. I usually do that in the first part of any Let's Play I do, but, yeah. There's basically, three or four types of bonus games you're gonna be playing. There's Find the Coin, Collect the Stars, Collect the Green Bananas, which I think is a new one from the second game. And this one was also obviously Collect the Green Bananas. The bonus games are going to start off really easy, and then they'll progress and get harder as we get in later. Here's another new mechanic. Instead of Rambi, like he was in the second game, we have Ellie here. This is the replacement for him, I guess. If you hold Y, you can, you know, pick up barrels just like you could with the Kongs. She can't ram into enemies like Rambi could. But she'll have some more mechanics that we'll get into later. I think it's A that you use to jump off of her in midair, like if you're doing a Yoshi jump, like in Super Mario World. So yeah, that is pretty much the first level here. There we go. Three ways you can tell if you 100%ed a level. One, if that flag that we got at the end there was all, like, not unfolded, basically, or if it was unfurled all the way, like you see on the map, it's also unfurled. And if there's a exclamation point next to the level name, you know you got in all the bonus barrels. If there's a yellow pennant thing next to the flag, like I'm standing to right now, that means you got in the DK coin. So we 100%ed the first level. Second level, Doorstop Dash. Yeah, a lot of the levels in the Donkey Kong Country games like to have alliteration as the titles, which I'm a big fan of because I love alliteration. I usually put it as the video titles, like, sometimes. So, yeah. Whoa, I didn't think I can do that. Yeah, if you do a roll, sometimes you can, like, it'll go longer and you can knock out, like, enemies. Like, longer, I guess. I don't know. Just know that it helps. I think the mechanic of this level is these doors that open and close. Basically, I love this game just because every level has a different mechanic. Like, the first, or not that the second and first games didn't have, like, weren't gimmicky, but I just like this game because it is more gimmicky than the other two games. I mean, I love that every level has a different feel, and, like, if you go into one and go into a level, you can tell, like, what level it is just by looking at it and seeing how the gimmicks work. I don't know, it's just so cool to me. And I guess the whole Donkey Kong Country series in itself is a really gimmicky series, but I don't know, I guess that's why I like it so much. It's just really fun. That and along with the music. I mean, this game doesn't have as good of music as the second game, I will concede that. The second game has probably the best music in the whole series, I think anyone can agree with that. But this game, I think it has better gameplay than the second game. I mean, it held my interest better than the second game, so, yeah. Also, those are bees. They returned from the second game. They were in the first level, but I forgot to introduce them. The green ones are able to be killed with barrels like this. There's also red ones that we'll see later, which can only be killed by TNT barrels, but... So basically, they're pretty much unkillable in a regular situation. Just go with that. Yeah, also, every level, except for the later secret levels that we'll be getting into, like the Lost World levels, like in the second game, Every level except for those will always have two bonus barrels and one DK coin to find, so you know you've 100% of the level even without going in it if you found two bonus barrels, which this is the second one that I'm going into, so it means that I did 100% it. This one can be kind of... These hooks don't really do anything, they just help you get up. And there we go, there's a coin. Also, Dixie pretty much breaks a lot of stuff because of her hair spin that you can do if you hold... I think if you jump, then you hold Y along with your jump, then you can do the hair spin like that. It lets you reach specific platforms and things later in the game. And it's actually needed to get into some bonus barrels. So yeah, speaking of the bonus barrels, if you fail one, which I might show eventually, I'll show it eventually, but I mean, in this first world I probably won't because they're actually not that hard. If you fail a bonus barrel, it'll bring you back to a specific spot, which will also be the same spot if you did win the bonus barrel, and for right here you want to stay there right because this is where you get coin. So yeah, if you fail the bonus barrel, you have a chance to go back and get it. Like, it's not you miss out on it for the whole level and you can't go back. So it's definitely more forgiving than, like, I guess it compared to the new Super Mario Bros. Series, even though this is way better than that series, but it's just a comparison. Yeah, oh, see, Dixie Kong breaks that so hard because of her hair spin. And that's the level, pretty much. 100%ed and everything. So yeah, another wrinkly save cave. I don't really feel the need to save, so I don't think I will. Onto the third level, and also, some of the later levels do get kind of hard, so I'm probably going to try to get as most lives I can, obviously, because... Well, I'll probably need them, let's just say that. Also, well, I say also a lot, but there's a lot to explain, so I guess also is a very good word to, you know, use it. If Dixie obviously holds barrels above her head, and I'm so used to this game, but then, you know, you have slip-ups like that, because I haven't recorded anything in, like, a week or so, but, Kitty here, if you, he holds barrels in front of him, and the different Kongs can be used to get different things, like killing the clobbers, I think they're called here. They'll run at you. I think there was a counterpart in Donkey Kong Country 2, but they weren't like living barrels. They were like Kremlings that were actually in the barrels. So yeah, oh, I forgot to get... There's another animal buddy that I forgot to get, and ow. First instance of losing a Kong, I guess. I'm surprised I got through the first three levels without taking a hit. I guess that's surprising. Anyway, I'm not sure if this was in the second game. I really can't remember. But you can actually turn into animal buddies sometime. Okay. Well, first death, of course, you know, after I say everything's all easy. Also, I guess this gives me a chance to show if you die, you don't have to collect any of the bonus tokens or the DK coin you got in the level again because, well, it saves it, basically. Also, there's Kong letters that you can get just like the first two games. Unlike the first game, in the second and third games, they're not required for 100%. They just get you a life if you get them at the end of the level, or if you get all of them throughout the level. So I guess it's kind of helpful in that sense, but if they're out of the way, I'm probably not going to go for them. I missed the thing again, didn't I? I just praised the game for being really original, like in the last level. But some of the levels do look kind of similar. Like this one kind of looks similar to the first level, except it has a more sunsetty feel, I guess you could say. Yeah, on guard there. If you press Y, or if you're nearing an enemy, he'll automatically do like that attack like that. I'm pretty sure you can also press A. Those spiny guy things, you have to hit them when they're open, or else you'll take a hit from it, obviously. And there's the bonus thing, bonus coin, yeah. Unlike the DKC2, they're not Kremling coins, I think, like they were in that game. They just have a giant B on them. I think they actually have the same symbol that the bonus barrels do, so that's cool. Also, unlike the second game, all the bonus barrels in this game are actually barrels. There's no, like, cannons or going inside of different holes to get to bonus barrels, like in one of the Hornet levels, I think in Donkey Kong Country 2. So yeah, that's pretty good. So you know, like, whenever there actually is a bonus barrel, those birds, like, they're, if you hit them with something, they'll pretty much always give you some sort of loot. Sometimes they're required. Sometimes they're not. Oh, I just screwed myself out of that bonus barrel. Well, this is actually good because it gives me a chance to show something off when we beat the level. Well, two things, actually. One, I can show what it looks like to not 100% a level. And two, I can show how you go back and get stuff throughout the level without having to do the whole level again. Which is good, in my opinion, because, you know, certain series, New Super Mario Bros., makes you have to go through the whole level again just to 100% a certain thing. I think this is the end of the level. Oh, I can break this with Kitty. I don't actually know what's in here. Oh, no, get back here. Shoot him up. What is down here? Oh, just one life. Lives in this game, like I said, they're balloons. Red ones are worth 1, green ones are worth 2, and blue ones are worth 3, I think. Yeah, I'm pretty much sure that's it. So yeah, if we go back into the level, I'm actually just going to cut to where... No, I don't have to cut. Jeez. I'm sorry if this seems so frazzled, but... Or if I'm rushing, but... I don't know. I'm not used to... I've been playing this game a lot recently, you know, just to practice it. Because this game, like I said, can get sort of hard later parts. It's definitely... It's probably the easiest of the three games. Well, I actually don't know, because I haven't played the first one through all the way. But it's definitely easier than the second one, in my opinion. So that's good. So I guess, I guess I could say why I chose to do this game. It's basically just because I wanted to do something other than Mario or Zelda. Because, you know, that's pretty much what my channel consists of. Basically, all Mario games and one Zelda game. I'm not gonna make that. What? How? I've made that before. God. Anyway. I'm gonna show this now just because I can. Well, no. Start select. If you press start, then select, you can exit a level if you've already beaten it, and you'll keep the collectibles you got in it. So yeah, that's what I wanted to show. Oh, halfway barrel. That's cool. Those are also halfway barrels. Jeez, I'm missing a lot of stuff to explain. Anyway, why I chose to do this game just because, you know, I've done a lot of more generic Nintendo stuff, and I think this game is very underrated. And I wanted to give it some more attention, so I think it's good that I'm being able to do it. I've seen like one other Let's Play on this game. Shoot. I've seen like one other Let's Play on this game, and that was only recently, so I don't know. I just like this game. It's good. If you haven't played it yet, you should. Hey, that rhymed. I'm just struggling to talk, something to talk about, jeez. Oh yeah, what I was also trying to do there, I was trying to do like a jump the kitty can do in the water. You can like, if you do like, no, you can like hop on water twice, and now I'm just messing up things that are easy. If you jump on water twice with kitty, it's required in some other levels. It's not required here, you can actually use Dixie's hair, but I'm failing at it, so I was trying to do something else. You know what, I'll just cut to when I actually get it, because I don't feel like, you know, leaving this in, because it's pretty boring. Well, actually, we're already here, so maybe I will just keep this in. See, like, certain things like that are easier to get with Dixie than Kitty. There, oh, no, I'm releasing it too soon, aren't I? Oh, jeez. There we go. Now, if I'm already failing at this early in the game, this has got to be a great sign for how things are going to go later in the game, jeez. Anyway, bash the baddies. Oh yeah, that's another one. Another form of a bonus game you can get. This one, obviously, really easy. You just had to bash the ladybugs there. I think they're called, what, knickknacks or something? Now, before I take a hit, exit the level. There we go. 100%ed. And in the next part of Donkey Kong Country 3... we'll be taking on a snow level in World 1. Sounds weird, but it's actually pretty easy. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you then.